Hey, Dr. C here with you. So which did you treat first, your thyroid or your adrenals? I got a question just like this from Monica yesterday. And Monica said, hey, Dr. C, I saw the Thyroid Reset Diet. I really want to try this out. But my practitioner said I've got to treat my adrenals first. But I've also heard some say you've got to treat the thyroid first. I'm not sure what to do or where to get started. So I've heard so many versions of that question. And as often is the case, there's a kernel of truth behind that. We'll talk about it. But here's how it's presented. So a lot of people have been told they've got abnormal thyroid levels. Many of them are on treatment. Many of them are doing diet therapies. Many are on medications. And a lot of these same people have symptoms that are told relate to their adrenal function. Some are told they've got adrenal fatigue. Some are doing things for this. And there's this idea floating around that there is a sequence. And if you goof up the sequence, you might explode or, you know, bad things will happen. I almost imagine like you're, you know, trying that last time for the password to get into your bank account or something, and one more failed attempt will be locked out. You know, like the sequence matters. So that's the situation. A lot of folks are totally stressed. They have symptoms. They're not feeling well. They want to do things about it. And they have entertained dietary approaches, supplements, you know, medications, but they're scared to death about getting the order wrong. So what's up with this? What do we do about it? Well, the idea is that the sequence comes from a real thing. So the real thing is the situation in which someone has overt untreated hypothyroidism and untreated adrenal insufficiency. And in this case, it's dangerous to treat the thyroid before treating the adrenals. So in this scenario, there is an order. And the reason for that is adrenal hormones and thyroid hormones, they interact. And specifically, a lack of thyroid hormones can make someone excrete their adrenal hormones more slowly. So what's the relevance of that? Well, if your thyroid's quit working and your adrenals have quit working, then the only saving grace is the fact that your adrenal hormones circulate a little longer than they would otherwise because your thyroid is so slow. Your body can't clear much of anything. You can't detox stuff. So if you took someone like that and just did appropriate thyroid replacement, but didn't treat their adrenal insufficiency, you could worsen the acute issues of their adrenal insufficiency because now they're going to dump those hormones out again and there's barely any there to work with. So that's the real pitfall. But who does that apply to? How common is that? Well, almost no one. So this is not adrenal fatigue. This is not adrenal stress. This is adrenal insufficiency. This is where the adrenals are actually unable to make enough hormone. The most common cause of this by far is Addison's disease, and that applies to only 3 to 5 people per every million people. So this is extremely rare. This is not the same thing as adrenal stress. And this is overt hypothyroidism that is untreated. So how common is it that someone has both these conditions and they're on treatment for neither? Well, I guess it's possible, and I'm sure there have been case reports, but this is not at all a common scenario. And over here, the idea of having some thyroid problem and some adrenal concern, those are extremely common, and those two things overlap quite a bit. So this involves probably, I don't know, a quarter of adults have at least thyroid antibodies, and probably the bulk of them have some symptoms that could be ascribed to be adrenal symptoms. So this might be 20% of adults, 15% of adults. Whereas over here, the adrenal insufficiency all by itself is a few per million. Let's make it easy math, say 1 per million. And then overt untreated hypothyroidism, that's less than about a few percent. So a few percent of 1 per million, now we're talking about maybe 1 per 100 million. And now we'll say someone like that, that's on no medical treatment or guidance, well, that's even rarer. This is probably no exaggeration in the few per billion. So this could happen, but this is not likely happening. And this is not likely happening to you. So the reality though, if you have thyroid disease and your adrenals are not right, well, what is the order? You know, what do you do? What can go wrong? The short answer is anything you do that helps one of those things will not hurt the other. So please don't worry. Anything you do that makes your adrenals healthier will only make things better for your thyroid and vice versa. Now, I'd also like to say that they're very different scenarios. So the most common problems that present with a thyroid are actual disease, and they're almost all autoimmune. They're generally circumstances in which the body's immune system is attacking the thyroid. You know, and that manifests as Hashimoto's, which can lead to hypothyroidism or can lead to Graves' disease. We can see these as the most common autoimmune versions. Now, that's disease. Adrenal issues are more matters of dysfunction. They're not where the body is broken. They're where the body is trying to juggle things. So these are cases where there's been a heightened chronic stress response, and the body is trying to adjust the hypothalamus, the pituitary, and the adrenals to adapt to chronic stressors. So it's not that something is broken, it's something that's just out of balance, whereas the disease state, something could be broken or breaking. Now, if your thyroid is not right, the question is, do you need to be on medication if you're not already? Well, if we're talking about overt hypothyroidism, meaning extremely high TSH plus well below range T4 plus symptoms, medications can help. You may not require medications. You may have options for diet therapy as well, but medications can be helpful. If we're talking about anything less than that, medications don't help. That data is really clear. They're not useful. And if you were put on treatment for a situation other than overt hypothyroidism, you may not need to stick with medication. You've got the option for diet therapy. Now, the easiest approach there is the thyroid reset diet. We've had large clinical trials showing that the vast majority of adults can full-on reverse thyroid disease in a few months. So what if you've got adrenal stress? Well, you can address that with diet as well. And the cool thing is you can do both at the same time. It's actually really easy. So if your adrenals are off, grab the Adrenal Reset Diet. There's a quiz in the book, and the quiz guides you to one of four different adrenal levels. Figure out that level, take the quiz, and do those recommendations. And in those recommendations, take a look at the food list in the Thyroid Reset Diet and stay on the green light foods. And you'll get a 2-for-1. You'll get both of them addressed at the same time. So you don't have to worry about an exact sequence. You don't have to wait when things are off. You can make safe lifestyle changes. And for many people, you may have the option of improving your thyroid without medication or with less medication. So that's it. Dr. C here with you. Take great care, and I'll see you really soon. Bye-bye.